this tutorial, I am going to talk how we can take care of a part of FI, and also how we can read and write FI. For this, I am going to use the command button. I am going to double click on this part 18, change the label to part 18, okay, and right click, callback, generate callback, and in the C file I am going to delete unnecessary events, and I am going to replace it under my callback functions, and I am going to use almost the same variables. I'm going to copy and paste here. The character S is not necessary, but I need a file name and a string, and I need a integer I, and two file pointer IFP and OFP, and here I am going to use same functions. I am going to select the file in the pop-up and put the file and put it in the file name, and I am going to open this file for both read and write. And I am going to press Ctrl P, and in this frame I am changing it to write and read, and press Ctrl I, and I am going to open the file for read only, and I am going to read the each row and put it in our text box, and I am going, because it is after this while the cursor is the end of the file, I am going to use rewind EFP. I am going to go back to the beginning of the file, and I am going to use I am going to count the lines, and here I use line, and I am going line equals 0, and I am going to use plus plus line. I am going to read each line in each step. If it is not null, if it is not the end of the file, then I am going to decrement the line, and I am going to close F close EFP, and I am going to use OFP foopen file open file name, this one for write to write, and then I am going to use a for loop for I equals 0, I less than line, plus plus I. I am going to use if pre it is a file pointer and it is OFP with the format string, and I am going to write a message. It was an example for text file. I am going to put in each row in the file name that phrase, and then I am going to use fclose OFP. Now I am going to compile. Error. One error. Use of undeclared. Yes, it is M here. I am going to put an M. Now I'm going to press part 18 and I am going to go to a directory. The context of file appear here, and I am going to go under my directory and open. Yes, it is. It was an example for text file. It was an example for text file, and it appear one after each other. And I really wanted use a new line here that each line is up here. So okay, I am going to use quit and I am going to go back here. I open it, it's empty. I am going under my documents. Here is my file. And going back to my control V dot here, and save, close, and in the to run again my file. Now I'm going to select the part 18 and under this I am using that file load, and it appear here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I am going back to my directory, open this. Yes, it was an example for text file 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lines. Okay, then it works. Okay, it was in the all in this tutorial. See you in next tutorial.